I'm going to teach you the difference between containers and virtual machines. As a DevOps engineer, you need to understand when to use a container versus a virtual machine and the technical and business consequences of your choice. Let's begin. Welcome to the second lesson of Docker from Zero to Infinity series. My name is Raghav, and here's my first question to you. Why do containers and virtual machines seem so similar? For starters, both of these are virtualization technologies. Suppose you have a big computer with lots of CPU, memory, disk storage, network bandwidth, and other resources. Virtualization is a technique to create logical boundaries inside the single computer to give the illusion that there are multiple smaller computers with their own resources. This allows different users to have their own computers without giving them access to the main underlying computer. Virtualization enables much better utilization when you have a large amount of resources that you would like to distribute amongst multiple users. Now, here's the main difference between containers and VMs. A virtual machine virtualizes the entire host machine down to the hardware level, but a container only virtualizes above the operating system. Other differences arise as a consequence of this simple fact. Containers are usually much lighter and more resource efficient compared to VMs. This means they consume lesser CPU and memory to run and start much faster. Containers run on top of the operating system. This means that OS must support features such as C groups and namespaces that allow containerization. VMs don't need an OS. They can directly run on the hardware. VMs are a lot more secure compared to containers. They provide a stronger level of isolation because systems are running their own operating system. Containers are all running on the same OS. So even a single malicious container can damage the entire OS and all other containers and applications on it. So when do I use which? Use containers to deploy microservices. This ensures that what worked during development also works in the production infrastructure. It also lets you deploy multiple services on the same machine. Better resource utilization. Other workloads such as cron jobs, background workers, internal tooling backends should also be deployed as containers. Also very useful for CI/CD pipelines. All your build jobs can run as containers. In fact, all major CI/CD tools now support containerized jobs, and some of them only work with containers. Even during local development, you can use containers to run your app and all its dependencies such as database or cache without polluting your computer itself. But do not deploy production databases inside containers. Use virtual machines when you want to try out a different operating system. They're also good for development environments, especially if you're building software for a different platform. But also use VM when you want stronger isolation boundaries. For example, when you're creating a multi-tenant system like infrastructure as a service. Cloud offerings such as AWS EC2 do exactly this. They run multiple VMs on a big underlying computer, and then these VMs can be used by different customers. You can also run data stores such as MySQL, Kafka, or Elasticsearch inside VMs. In fact, all cloud providers are already doing that. Penetration testers also use virtual machines to set up labs to analyze malware. This protects their own computer from any harm. Here are some popular container providers. Can you guess their names without Googling? Docker is obviously the most popular one, but the others have their use cases too. How about virtual machine providers? Can you use containers and VMs together? Of course you can. Every time you deploy a Docker container on an EC2 server or an AWS Lambda function, you are running a container on top of a virtual machine. Docker Desktop, the software we use to run Docker on Mac and Windows, actually runs on a Linux VM under the hood. But the other way around, which is running a VM inside a container, makes no sense to me at all. And I don't know why someone would do that. So this is how containers and virtual machines differ from each other. They both have their respective use cases. There is some overlap, but neither of them replaces the other. I want to know how you use containers. How did you find out about Docker in the first place? Let's discuss in the comments. In the next lesson, I will do a deep dive into Docker's architecture. Keep leveling up your DevOps game with me. Subscribe to my channel now. If you learned something interesting from my video, press the like button. It would mean the world. See you in the next video.